Is winter over yet? Oh, hey! You're back for another Wildlife Wednesday. Come on, let's take a look around.
Hello, and welcome back to another Wildlife Wednesday. James,
where are we on this glorious January day?
Here we are at the natural wonder of Governor Dodge State Park, known as Stevens Falls.
Now, as we're down here at Stevens Falls, I mean, this is an absolutely incredible area. Because of all the moisture and the very shady area, it creates an environment unlike many other environments found here in the driftless area of Wisconsin. And because of that completely different environment, you have totally different plant communities and animal communities and a whole range of different ecosystems and everything that goes on here that really makes this a unique place. Let's go a little bit deeper into it.
What kind of rock is that?
That? Oh, that rock up there, James?
Yeah.
That's just your good old sandstone. You know, we have a lot of sandstone around here in the driftless area. And boy, oh boy, this is a classic example of sandstone. A relatively soft sandstone at that, allowing this water to carve right through it.
So what we got here is a type of fern moss. And fern moss is part of the family Thudiaceae, genus Thudium. And this moss, it's a real hardy type of moss. So it grows really well in cold weather. It can tolerate up to -5 degrees Fahrenheit. And this stuff will just keep growing, as you can see here in the winter. And it also prefers acidic type soils. And that's what you get when they grow on the side of the sandstone here. That's a really acidic rock. And so the plant does really well here. And as you can see, there's a lot of it. We also got another type of non-vascular seedless plant growing on the rock here. And this is what's known as snakewort, which is in the family Conocephalaceae.
All right, so now I already mentioned how this was a completely different environment from most of the driftless area because it's much cooler and shadier than most of the surrounding area. However, because of that, it creates these habitats that allow for trees like this to grow here. This tree that we're looking at right now is known as Blue Beech or the American Musselwood. Now, this is a very, very strange tree to find here. It usually grows around the Great Lakes and in northern Wisconsin where it can really, you know, tolerate those cold, wet conditions, you know, like you would find around the Great Lakes. However, because we're in such a cool, damp, moist environment created by the stream and the low elevation in this valley, it creates the perfect habitat for this musselwood to grow here, which is quite an amazing tree. One of my favorite in Wisconsin. Okay, let's keep it going.
Play music behind this.
Now, you may recognize this as a birch. However, this is not your normal paper birch. This is a little bit more cold and wet tolerant yellow birch. Now, absolutely incredible. Not something you would normally see here unless you're down in a cooler river, maybe a little bit further north as well. And it's characterized by this very thin, kind of shaggy, you could say almost a little bit yellowish bark to it. It's very, very cool bark. And this, for a yellow birch, is an absolute gigantic birch. I mean, it's huge. Fantastic. An old growth birch. Does it really get much better than an old growth yellow birch, James?
I don't think so.
I don't think so either.
In the summertime, Stevens Falls is also a great place to find one of my favorite animals, salamanders. And there are a number of different salamander species that you can find down here, specifically mole salamanders, otherwise known as ambystoma. And that would include your marbled salamander, tiger salamander, and perhaps even the blue-spotted salamander if you're lucky. Now we also get types of lungless salamanders, which are known as plethodontae. And those are a little bit smaller. You got your red-black salamander and a few others. And they absorb oxygen through their skin, which is why they're called lungless. Now, if you come out sometime this summer, you won't find them now, but they're usually, they love Stevens Falls. If you come out for summer camp, you might get a chance to see one of those bad boys.
James and I had an absolutely fantastic little hike down here at Stevens Falls. And, you know, while it's nice to be here in the winter, it's gorgeous, there's icicles, we really hope that you guys can come out during the summer, maybe even with summer camp, and join us in a wonderful hike around here in much warmer weather. A thing of beauty, James. And so with that, thank you for watching this episode of Wildlife Wednesday. And until next time, make sure you get outside, get out to a place like this if you can, and
enjoy the natural splendor.